IIET-NCERT presents audiobook Introductory Macroeconomics.
Page 25.
Module 2, Money and Banking. Module 2.1, Money. Rationale. Money and banking are crucial for the functioning of modern economy. They enable the flow of funds for the production, distribution of goods and services both within and outside the economy. Key concepts: money, functions of money, demand for money, money supply.
2.1.1. Money. In economics, money is anything that is commonly accepted as a medium of exchange. For example, Ram Purari buys 1 kg of wheat and he uses a rupees 50 note for buying it. By exchanging a rupees 50 currency note with the shopkeeper, Ram Purari gets wheat. The shopkeeper, in turn, uses the same currency note to buy a bulb for his shop. This rupees 50 note acts as a medium of exchange and is called money. Instead of notes, anything else which is acceptable to everyone in the society as a medium of exchange is considered as money. There was a time in history when shells, metals, and even cows were exchanged as money. Paper notes and coins are the form in which money exists in our society today. Apart from being used to buy goods and services today, money is also used to buy goods and services in the future. Let's say Ahmed Hassan has earned rupees 2 lakhs, but his monthly expenditure is only rupees 50,000. His savings of rupees 1.5 lakh can be kept in the form of cash, which can be used to buy goods and services in future.
2.1.2. Functions of money. This is a flowchart indicating how the functions of money can be understood. The label functions of money is then further trifurcated into means of payment, store of value, unit of account.
Page 26.
Money performs the following functions.
1.
Means of payment or medium of exchange. If there were no medium of exchange, then in order to buy bread, I would need to find someone who can sell me bread in exchange for something that I am willing to sell. For example, shoes. This system of exchange is called barter system and is extremely inconvenient. The inconvenience is removed with the help of a common means of payment or medium of exchange, which is money. It has general acceptability.
2.
Store of value. When people earn more than they wish to spend, in any time period, say a year or month, their excess earnings become their savings. These savings can be kept in the form of different kinds of assets, such as bonds or diamonds or gold or as cash. If the extra earnings are kept as cash rather than bonds, it can be easily used as a means of payment to buy goods and services at any time. Till then, money stores value or acts as a store of value.
3.
Unit of account. We can measure the value of all goods and services in terms of money. For example, if the value of a pair of slippers is rupees 200, money acts as a unit in terms of which the value of slippers is measured. Here, money acts as a standardized unit of value. If money had not been there, different people would assign different values to the pair of slippers, depending on their need for it. When measured in terms of money, everyone puts the same value, that is, rupees 200, for a pair of slippers.
2.1.3. Demand for money and its determinants. The demand for money tells us what makes people desire a certain amount of money. It should be noted that we are not asking how much people want to earn, but only how much money they want to keep as means of payment or store of value. What determines demand for money? People want or demand money in order to conduct transactions, that is, for buying goods and services. How much money people demand for this reason depends on the value of transactions they do. A person with higher income will need to do more transactions. The number of transactions thus rises with a rise in income. Thus, as income increases, demand for money rises, thereby depicting a positive relation between the two. It is graphically drawn in figure 2.1, where the money demand curve slopes upward, showing this relation. The x-axis measures the demand for money for transactions motive, and the y-axis measures the income.
Page 27.
Figure 2.1, relation between demand for money and income. Here we have a graph with two axes, x and y. X-axis represents quantity of money demanded, or MD. Y-axis represents income, or Y. As we can understand that as income increases from Y1 to Y2, the quantity of money demanded also increases from M1 to M2. This has been represented with an upward sloping line, MD. Value of transactions also depends on the price level in the economy. As the prices rise, the demand for money is increased. This is graphically illustrated in figure 2.2, where the x-axis measures the demand for money, or MD, for transactions motive, and the y-axis measures the price level, or P. The demand for money is proportional to the price level, and the curve slopes upward, showing this relation.
Page 28.
Figure 2.2. Relation between demand for money and price level. Here, we have a graph with two axes, X and Y. X-axis represents quantity of money demanded, or MD. Y-axis represents price level, or P. As we can understand from this, that with an increase in price level from P1 to P2, the quantity of money demanded increases from M1 to M2. This has been represented with an upward sloping line, MD. Thus, the demand for money rises with the value of transactions, that is, with the price level and income. Under the speculative motive, the demand for money also depends on the rate of interest. However, people prefer to keep cash balance as an alternative to financial assets like bond. When people use money as a means of payment in the future, they can buy some other assets like bonds, which earn some return. Money in the form of cash does not earn any return, whereas assets like bonds earn a return. When the rates of interest rise, a person holding money will lose to a person holding bonds. Hence, with an increase in the rate of interest, the amount of assets kept in the form of money or demand for money falls. A rise in the rate of interest reduces the demand for money, and a fall in the rate of interest increases the demand for money. In this way, the rate of interest and the demand for money move in the opposite directions. Figure 2.3 represents this, where the x-axis measures the demand for money, or MD, for speculative motive, and the y-axis measures the rate of interest, or I. The graph depicts that as the interest rate rises, the demand for money falls. The demand for money curve slopes downward, showing this relation.
Page 29.
Figure 2.3. Relation between the rate of interest and the demand for money. Here, we have a two-axis graph. X-axis represents quantity of money demanded, or MD. Y-axis represents rate of interest, or I. From this, we can understand that with an increase in rate of interest from I1 to I2, the quantity of money demanded decreases from M1 to M2. This has been represented with a downward sloping curve, MD. Thus, the demand for money is affected by three variables, income or Y, price level or P, and the rate of interest or I. Table 2.1 lists the impact of income, price level, and interest rate on demand for money. Table 2.1, variables affecting demand for money. Here, we have a table with three columns and four rows. The first column tells us about the variable. The second column tells us about the direction of change. The third column tells us about the impact on demand for money. In row 2, it is indicated that income or Y increases, and hence the impact on demand for money is that it also increases, that is, the transactions demanded increase. In the third row, we identify that price level increases. The impact on demand for money is that it also increases, that is, the transactions demanded increase. In the third row, it is indicated that interest rate increases. The impact on demand for money is that it decreases. This is speculative demand.
2.1.4. Money supply. After discussing money demand, we move to a discussion of how this money is created or supplied. It is obvious that you and I cannot create money at will. The government of any country controls the amount of money which can be supplied, and this is done through the banking system of the country. Before we go on to see how the banking system creates, that is, supplies money, let us understand that generally money is kept either in the form of currency, that is cash, and coins in the form of deposits in banks, which can be withdrawn very easily.
Page 30.
There are various measures of money called capital M1, capital M2, capital M3, and capital M4. However, we focus on M1, or what is also called the narrow measure of money. Narrow money includes currency and demand deposits with banks. This has been represented pictorially. The label currency plus the label demand deposits equals the label narrow money, capital M1. Currency refers to cash and coins. Demand deposits are those bank deposits on which checks can be written, and in this way, they can be used to make payments or to buy things. Payments can be made through writing checks on these deposits or through usage of debit cards. Both checks and debit cards thus act as close substitutes for cash. Demand deposits are considered as good as cash and therefore are called money. Apart from M1, there are other measures of money which can be classified under broad money. Broad money includes various kinds of deposits other than demand deposits. For example, fixed deposits. These deposits may also be substituted for cash, but not as easily as demand deposits. However, most important measure remains M1, and we will focus on it in the next module. Bank money, that is deposits, is an important part of total money. So, we need to understand how banks function in order to understand how money is created by them.
Test your understanding.
1.
Identify the function of money in the following statements.
A.
Money facilitates the sales and purchase of goods or commodities.
B.
It works as a common denomination in which values of all goods and services are expressed.
C.
Money facilitates the payments for all transactions of goods and services.
D.
Money facilitates transfer of purchasing power from the present to the future.
2.
What happens to the demand for money if the rate of interest decreases in an economy?
You were just listening to this chapter. Subject Coordinator, Dr. Jaya Singh. Production Assistant, Jagbandhu Jana. Sound Recordist, Batilang Lindo and Vikas Sangwan. Artists, Anandana Kapoor and Akash Ahuja. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And presented by CIET, NCERT, New Delhi, India.